Hey guys, this is Marie and I'm back with another video. And this video is going to be how to set up play sand in EcoEarth substrate. So let's get started. So in this video, I'm just going to show you step by step how to make your own substrate with play sand and EcoEarth dirt. So here we go. So I wanted to make this video for you guys because when I started out with Hermit Crabs, I didn't know how to make the play sand and EcoEarth substrate for my Hermit Crabs. And it took me a very long time to find a video that actually somebody did make on YouTube how to make the substrate with the play sand and the EcoEarth. So there's not a lot of videos out there to show you how to make the right stuff. So I thought this would be a great video to show all the newcomers are becoming a Hermit Crab owner. And even the ones that are hermit crab owners, this would be a great video for you guys too. Alright, so let's go ahead and get into it. So as you guys can see, this is my 20 gallon tall tank. And I'm going to go step by step to show you how to clear everything out with your substrate and then make the new substrate to put back in. So the first step you want to do is take everything out of your tank. So I'm going to go ahead and start that, and I'll be back in a little bit. Okay, so far I got a few things out, and here it is right here. I got some of the hermit crabs out, their shells, their food and water dish, one plant, and their log. So I'm going to go back and do a few more items to take out of the tank, and I'll be back in a little bit. Okay guys, so this is what the finished project looks like. Everything is out of the tank, and the only thing left I have to do will be just take out the other stick. I usually leave it in when I clean the tank because it is a very hard time putting it in there, but since I'm going to redo the whole tank, I'm going to have to take it out. So I will be back in a little bit to do that. Alright, so I got the last log out. So this is what the tank looks like now. Everything is cleared out and empty inside of the tank. And this is what the substrate looks like. I had this substrate in here for about almost a year. Usually you should take your substrate and change it out at least every 6 months to a year and put new fresh stuff in there. So it could be between 6 months to a year to go ahead and change it out. Mine's been about a year, so it's good. Very good time to change it out now. Alright, so let's go ahead and go into the second step, and that's going to be taking out the substrate and putting that in the trash. So I will be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so I got some of it out. This is what it looks like so far. And all I'm doing is just putting it in the trash can. So I'll go ahead and show you what I'm doing. So you'll just take like a little shovel or something and just scoop it up and then just put it inside the trash can. So it's pretty simple. Whatever works for you would be the best to use. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and go a little further in this and I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so this is what it looks like so far. I am almost on the bottom of the tank, so it's going to be a very long process to let you guys know. If you have a lot of sand like I do, it will probably take a very long time to get it all out. But you just keep on working on it until it's completely filled and empty, and then you'll be good to go to start your next project. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and get back into it, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so here is the bottom of the tank. I am halfway there. This is what the one side looks like. And then this is the side that has the no sand and all the way down to the bottom of the tank. So I'm getting there. It's going to be a long process like I said, but you just keep going until you finish. So I'm going to go ahead and try to get the rest of it out and then I'll be back to start the next project with you guys. Alright guys, so this is what the tank looks like with no sand. I just have a little bit left to do, so I will just go ahead and just show you so you guys get the idea of how to, you know, get rid of your old sand and put it in the trash so you can start the new fresh sand. So this is what we do. So So it's pretty simple. Just make sure you get all the sand out as much as you can, because the next step would be to clean out your tank. And the way you'll do that is you'll just put plain hot water in your tank and then just let your tank soak for a little bit, and then you'll wipe it out. But please do not put any kind of soap or anything in here, because that will kill your hermit crabs. So just make sure you just use really hot, plain hot water. And that will clean your tank out really well to get all the old stuff out so you can put the new stuff inside of your tank. Alright, so here we go. This is what the tank looks like with nothing in it. So the next step, like I said, is going to be is you will get some hot water, plain hot water, and you'll just pour it into your tank, and you're just going to wash it and clean it out really good to get all the old stuff out and any kind of bacteria or any kind of mold or anything that was inside of the tank. You want it completely out and clean so you can put the new stuff in. So I will be back in a little bit to show you how to put the water in and what to do. Okay guys, so the next step is going to be taking hot water that I got right here in my bucket and putting it inside of your tank so you can just wash it out and get everything that's old out, and so it could be brand new again. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and don't mind the noise outside. I'm just outside doing this so I don't mess up the carpet inside. So you just go ahead and pour plain hot water in there. And I'm going to go ahead and get at least one more bucket so I can start scrubbing it a little bit. So I will be back in a little bit. Alright, so now I have my second plain hot water in the bucket. And then I'm just going to go ahead and pour it in here very carefully. Alright. And then the next thing you'll do is just find something that you can use. I'm just going to use a plain paper towel and just wet it. And then just go each of your sides and just clean your sides and the bottom of the tank. Just to make sure everything is nice and clean and there's nothing that's old and disgusting on there. You'll probably have to do this at least 2 times. I'm guessing at least 2 or 3 times just to make sure everything is out and I don't miss anything, like dirt wise or any kind of bacteria or any kind of mold or anything that I'm missing. And then just make sure you get your little edges right here too, because there's always stuff there. I always get sand there for some reason, I don't know how, but alright, so I'm going to go ahead and finish this first project, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, I'm back, and I cleared out the water. I did a very good job. I just have the little bit of sand over there in the corner, because it was hard to get out because it was getting stuck underneath this little edge. So I'm just going to pour one more bucket of water and dump it over the edge, and then it should be nice and clean and good to go to the next step. Alright, there we go. So I'm going to go ahead and dump this out and then I'll be back. Alright guys, so the next step is going to be just drying off your tank. Just to make sure it is completely dry. There is no wet spots or anything left over inside of your tank. So that's what I'm about to do. You could just take a plain towel like I have right here, or just a paper towel, it doesn't matter, whatever is easier for you. And you'll just dry each side of the corners and the bottom of the tank. So it's pretty simple. My tank looks a lot bigger without everything in here and the sand. I was pretty surprised how big it was, because I haven't seen it in a while without nothing in it. This is all you pretty much do, so it's just pretty simple. It's an easy step. And I do have a little bit of water left over in here, so I'm just going to dry it up with this towel and it'll be good to go. And this is what my heater looks like, if you guys never seen it. I put it on the side right here. So the outside of it looks like this. And then the inside of it looks like that. And I started out on the bottom because usually when your hermit crabs molt, they usually go all the way down to the bottom so the heat can, you know, circulate inside of your tank. So that's what that looks like. Alright, so this is pretty much almost dry, so I'm going to go ahead and finish it up. And I will move on to step 4. Alright guys, I am back in the house and this is what the tank looks like. It is nice and clean and dried off completely. So that's what that looks like. Now your step 4 is going to be getting a bucket of plain water. And then you'll need your Equal Earth dirt, and that's what this is. And what you'll do is you'll just take the wrap off and just stick the Equal Earth inside of the water for about 20 to 30 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and unwrap it, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so this is what the Equal Earth brick looks like. And then you'll just stick it inside of the water. And then you're going to let it sit in the water for about 30 minutes and it'll start loosening up and it'll start looking like dirt. Kind of like that. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and let this sit for a little while. And then I'm going to go ahead and start the next step, and that's going to be number 5. And that will be using your play sand. So the next step will be taking your play sand and putting that inside of your tank. So I'm going to go ahead and open that and then I'll be back. Alright guys, so here is what the sand looks like. It's just normal play sand. So it's a very loose sand. And what you're going to do is while you're waiting on the Equal Earth, you're actually going to take the sand and put it into your tank. And then you're going to wet it with water and it'll start getting thick like ocean and beach sand. So I'm going to go ahead and put some in there and start getting it wet, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so I go ahead and I started putting the sand inside of the tank. All I'm doing is taking my little shovel looking thing and then just taking the sand and putting it inside of the tank. So I'm going to do this for a little while and get it filled up a little bit. And then you're going to go ahead and pour water in it and get it nice and beachy sandy like. Now I'm going to give you an update of what the Equal Earth dirt looks like. So it's almost finished. It didn't take as long as I thought it was going to. So this is what it looks like. So it just looks like plain dirt, basically. And the brick actually worked pretty well. I used to use this stuff a long time ago and it didn't work out as good as I wanted to, but it actually did a pretty good job this time, so I'm very happy about it. And I actually used really hot water, so that kind of boosted up and made it go a little faster and making it more dirty like. So that's what that looks like. So this is pretty much almost ready to go, so once I start getting the sand as the way I like it, then I can go ahead and start putting the dirt inside of it. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit more sand inside and then I'll be back a little bit. Alright guys, so now I put a little bit more of sand in there and I'm going to go ahead and take my hot bucket of water and I'm going to pour it inside of the tank and get the sand wet. And that's all you'll pretty much do. And then what you'll do is you'll just take your hand, and it's going to get very messy. So if you don't like the mess, you'll be okay. So then now it's going to start looking like play sand. So there you go. So you're just going to sit here and move the water around and then get all the dry sand nice and wet and moist. So that's what that is. And once you know that it starts clumping up and acting like play sand, then you know you did a good job and you're doing the way it's supposed to look. And I'm sorry there's not a lot of light because I don't have the tank light over here. So it's easier for me to get inside of the tank and start moving the sand around. But once I start getting a little bit more in here, I will bring the light back so you guys can see it in the light. Alright, so there is most of the stuff that's coming along. There's the sand. It's getting very good. And once you guys can start like packing it in and making something out of it like that, then you're pretty much good to go and you're pretty set. So now what you'll do is you'll just keep stirring it around as much as you can. And I pretty much got all the dry sand up already. So now I'm going to go ahead and go to the next part. And that would be putting more sand inside of this. And then adding more water and then just stirring it around and getting it thick like it's supposed to look. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and do that and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so I went on ahead and put more dry sand into the wet sand. And I got my little bucket of water again, and this is hot water. And what I'm doing is I'm just going to go ahead and pour it back in here again, just like you did the first time. And then once you finish that, you'll go ahead and mix it around again so you can get all the dry sand mixed in together with the wet sand. And once you start hearing that little loud crunchy sound and it starts getting where it's thick, where it's clumping together, then you are doing the right way. So I'm going to go ahead and mix a little bit more because there's still some dry sand on the bottom part. And this bag of sand, you guys can go to your local Lowe's and you can get a 50-pound bag for about $5. But I think because it's not the summertime yet, it was actually cheaper. I actually got it for $3, so that's not bad. So I picked the right time to actually get the bag of sand. If I would have waited probably back in August, I probably would have paid the $5. But I mean, that's still not bad for a bag of 50-pound sand. But $3 is even better. So if you are going to try to do this, I would try to get it now while it's on sale, and you'll have a 50-pound bag for $3. So there you go. So there's what the sand looks like. It's getting nice and clumpy, like beach sand. Alright, so now what I'm going to do is, since I started to play sand already, and it's probably about maybe an inch or two, I would say, maybe three. Now what you're going to do is get your Eco Earth dirt, and you're going to go ahead and start putting some of that inside of the tank. So I'm just going to get like a handful of it. And then just mix it around. And get another handful. And mix it around. And I'll do about another handful of it. And spread it around. So now what you're going to do is you're just going to take both Eco Earth and sand and just mix it around together to make it look like it's a little brown dark sand instead of a tan sand. And once I mix this up, I will go ahead and get the light for the tank and put it over here so you guys can get a better look of what it actually looks like. Alright, so now I got it mixed up, so I'm going to go ahead and get the light and turn it on, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so now I turned on the light so you guys can see exactly what it looks like. So this is what it looks like, close up, with some Eco Earth in of the play sand. So there we go. So it's coming along very well, and I'm very happy about it. It's doing great. I'm just going to keep stirring a little bit more, and then I'm going to go ahead and start adding more play sand and then adding more Eco Earth dirt. And then you'll do this until you get to the point where you need to have at least 6 to 8 inches of substrate inside of your tank, because you need to be have at least 6 to 8 inches to have your biggest hermit crab go down and molt and actually dig all the way down. So my biggest hermit crab right now is Pearl. So she's probably about this size. So if you would take her and put her up against here, see, that's what she would look like if she's down underneath the dirt. So you would have to say at least from here, this is what it looks like with the dirt, and she's already down here. Okay, let me put her back because she's grabbing on to me. Alright, so if she's right about here, then you need to have at least your sand and your substrate and your dirt at least up to here. So that should be about 8 inches. Now if you have small tiny hermit crabs like the most of mine are, then 6 inches will be okay, because they're usually about, you know, this small, and if you have about 6 inches, you'll be good to go. But if you have big and large and medium hermit crabs, then I would say go to at least the 6 to 8 inches, and that would be good for you. So when I get done with completely everything, I will go ahead and show you when I even it out of what 8 inches should look like and how far it looks like when it's deep down under. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit more sand and dirt, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so I went on ahead and put more play sand in there. So I'm going to go ahead and put a couple more scoops, and then I'm going to go ahead and put the Equal Earth. So I just wanted to show you guys exactly what you should do. So you just take your play sand and pour it inside of the tank. And then pour it inside of your tank. And I'm going to probably do at least one more. Alright, so now you're going to go ahead and take your Eagle Earth dirt, and you'll go ahead and put that in your hand and put it inside of the tank. And then you go ahead and put more in there. Okay, so now I'm going to take it and I'm going to get another bucket of water and pour it in here, and then I'm going to mix it around. So I will be back in a little bit. Alright guys, so I am back with the bucket of water again, and I'm just going to go ahead and pour it in here. And then you're going to go ahead and just stir it around and mix it around, just like you've been doing. And you might have little clumps of the Eco Earth, so you can just break it up with your hand, and then you'll be good to go with that. So the sand is coming along very well. I can tell it's getting really thick and beachy-like, and that's the kind of sand that you want for your hermit crabs. So I'm going to go ahead and keep stirring it around until it gets nice and mixed up together. Now, the last time I made substrate, the stowed stuff that you guys saw, I did use more sand than I did Equal Earth because I didn't like the Equal Earth dirt. So it's up to you. You can use more sand if you like the sand better than the Equal Earth, or you can use the Equal Earth more than the sand, or you can just use play sand by itself and you don't have to use the Equal Earth. But it's good to have a little dirt in there because it helps with the moisture. So I probably won't use all of the brick. I'll probably use at least half of it, but I'll probably use more sand. So I'll probably use the whole 50-pound bag of sand and half of the brick. It all depends on how it comes out on the end. But that's your choice. You can make your decision the way you want to. You don't have to use all of it. You can use some of it or half of it. It all depends on how you like it and what it looks like to you. So this is what the play sand and the equal earth looks like together. And it actually makes a different color once you put the equal earth in there, in the sand. It actually makes it a different color. It makes the sand a little bit darker, even when it's wet too. Alright guys, so now I'm going to go ahead and finish this up. And then when I get done, I will come back and show you what the finished product looks like. Alright, I'll be back in a little while. Hey guys, I'm back. And I'm just going to go ahead and show you what I did so far. I used the rest of the sand for the play sand and put it inside of here. And I used another part of the equal earth. And there's still a lot more left over. It's probably another half. So I kind of used only a half of the brick. So I'm not going to use the rest of this. I wanted more sand than I did want dirt. So I'm going to go ahead and just keep this or just throw it away. This is what it looks like on the end, on the bottom of your bucket, when you have a lot of extra water on the bottom. And if it looks like this, it's okay. Don't freak out. What you'll do is you'll just take it on the side and wring it out like a washcloth, like this. And then it will dry up and look like that. And then you'll just put it inside of your tank like this, and it looks like it's dry, like you never even put water in it. So that's what you'll do if it ever comes to that. And if you do put a little extra water in there, don't freak out, it's all right. Like I said, all you'll do is you'll just take a clump of it, dry it off, rinse it out like a washcloth, and then it'll dry up like that. So that's pretty simple. And then you'll just put it inside of your tank. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the bucket of water and stir this around, and then I'll go ahead and come back. Alright guys, so I got my last bucket of water, and I'm just going to go ahead and pour it in here. And I'll probably need another bucket, but I'm going to go ahead and mix it around first, because you don't want to have too much water in here. So let me see if I can mix it around and see what it looks like, if I'm going to need another bucket or not. I probably will, because I have more dry sand on the bottom. You want to make sure you get all of the dry sand completely wet. You don't want to have any dry spots. So I'm just keep stirring this and get it all nice and moist. And to show you how well the sand and the equal earth does very well, if you see my temperature gauge, if I can get it to focus. Come on, focus. Well, you can't really see it, but it says 70. So in this tank, without my heater, it is actually 70 degrees in here. So it's getting hot. Your tank should be at least 75 to 80. But without the heater being on, it's already 70 in here. So this is how well the equal earth and the sand works. I'm not saying you should not have a heater, because you should, but I'm just saying with just the equal earth and the sand, it helps it a lot, because it keeps your moisture very well inside of your tank. And the gauge right there proves it to you. And then once I put my heater back on and close this top up completely where no heat can get out and the humidity stays in, then it will go back to 75 and 80, and that will be perfect. So I got pretty much all of it mixed around, I think. I think I'm pretty well mixed. I'm going to go ahead and go to the bottom of it just to make sure. Now, the way for you guys to keep this sand nice and moist is every time that you clean out your tank, like take everything out like this, and you'll go ahead and just take everything out, the hermit crabs, your decorations, anything that you have in. You could do that at least once a month. Take everything out and just get a bucket of water, pour it over your sand and equal earth, and then just do like I'm doing right now, just mix it around so you always have nice clumpy sand and equal earth. Alright, so everything should looks pretty good now. I think it is nice and mixed up very good. I don't see any dry spots anywhere. And the sand is coming out very well because it's clumping good, as you guys can see right here. If I clump it together, it makes it nice and flat. So it's coming out very well. Now, when your hermit crab digs under your sand, he's going to go, you know, underneath there. Say I'm a hermit crab and I'm digging underneath. And they usually make like a little hole like this. And they'll dig under. And you know, the top of the sand, when they're down here, the hermit crab will stay right here. And they'll have like a little wall right here where it won't pack into them. And so when they're in there, you know, they're covered. This is covered like this. And that helps them to stay underneath there and to molt, and it looks, you know, very well, and it don't squish them. Now, if this was loose sand, like I just put loose sand in there, it won't be able to pack in there because it's so loose to where it will bury them, and they won't be able to molt, and they'll end up dying. So this is perfect sand for your hermit crab when they need to molt. Alright, so I think the sand is completely finished. So this is what the end of the product looks like. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go ahead and fix it up and clean the sides off and just make the sand look a little more even on the edges. So then I can show you how much sand is actually in here and how deep it is. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and do that and then I'll be back a little bit. Alright guys, so I am back and I went on ahead and straightened out the equal earth and placed sand and made it even to show you guys what it looks like. So that's what it looks like when it's evened out. And then here is the side of it. So I do this because then it shows me how much equal earth and placed sand or substrate that you have in your tank. So we have it from here to about here. So that's about, I would say, 8 inches. So that's what you should have if you have a medium to large hermit crab. Now if you have a small hermit crab like some of mine are, from here to about here is probably about 6 inches, and that would be okay. So I usually have mine around the same amount every time, so that's about 8 inches. And the way I could tell is opened up from where the heater is. Alright guys, so this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please comment down below. Please give this video a big thumbs up, comment down below, and definitely don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more. Until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!